Here's how to create a mermaid hair look adorned with LEDs. I've wanted to make a hair accessory like this since Diana Cowan and I met in 2018. This is actually her idea, but she's been incapacitated by long COVID. So I'm making this project with my hair and makeup artist, Hinano Lung, and sending our love to Diana in spirit. Now, y'all might be able to guess that Ariel was the only redheaded protagonist I saw in mainstream entertainment when I was a little kid. I even had the Little Mermaid bedsheet set. So Little Mermaid is inextricably linked to my childhood.
For this project, I'm using these tiny addressable LED pixels, but you could also use regular fairy lights as an alternative if you want a similar look without as much work. These wires are thin but solid, so they stay where you put them when bent and shaped. I had a really fun time sculpting two hair pieces from these strands, one for Hinano and one for me. For some of them, I clustered a few pixels together to make a larger shape. On others, I twisted each pixel up and branched it out from a central trunk. For both, I created a crown shape meant to be wrapped around the head, with a few hanging tendrils to interact with the rest of the hair or be shaped during styling. My smart LEDs need a microcontroller to tell them what color to be and when. I'm using the Xiao RP2040 board because it's super tiny, affordable, and you can code it up with Arduino like I did, or use CircuitPython if that's more your jam. Use sandpaper or a nail file to remove the thin coating protecting the wires, add some heat shrink, then solder the wires to your microcontroller's power, ground, and a digital output pin.
If you're new to all this, you can follow along with my Intro to Electronics series that I make for DigiKey, the sponsor for this video. Over on their channel, I can teach you everything you need to know to build this project, from soldering to LED programming. Check it out, as well as the write-up for this project, which has links to all the DigiKey products I used, including the LEDs, the microcontroller, the soldering tools, just to name a few.
I wanted the pieces to each feature a different color palette. I ended up modifying the sample rainbow function to only express part of the color wheel, blues and greens for Hinano's and reds and pinks for mine. I'm powering this project with a regular USB backup battery like you'd use to recharge your phone. The cable runs down from the back of the neck to a pocket. This is the safest option because the battery is sealed up inside an enclosure and not attached directly to your body. It's not like I haven't put bare lithium cells in my hair before, wrapped in tape and attached to a hair clip, but I can't recommend this because if something goes wrong with a live poly battery, it could heat up and burn you and potentially also catch fire to your hair. Using a backup battery also provides a lot of juice. The LEDs will shine for hours, and of course you can also still use it to charge your phone. I 3D printed seashell-shaped diffusers using transparent PLA filament. I printed them in two different sizes and used hot glue to affix them to the LEDs. This is an optional step. The LEDs look fine on their own, but it's really hard not to use 3D printing for everything once you've got the capability. I also got some perfectly fetching sea-themed hair clips on Amazon. These alone would work just fine. Hinano did my hair in a braided half updo.
What does the heat protector do, Hinano?
To protect the hot toes, burning the hair, and also help the curl stay longer.
It's like a primer.
Yeah, kind of.
My hairdresser says that the heat protectant burns off so that like it burns instead of the hair.
Yeah, something like that. And I feel like it really helps the curl sometimes. So when you curl your hair, you want to hit the whole section first with your curler. So it's kind of like this. Hit the whole section, so make your hair kind of like warm up. Then curling it, then the curl will last like way longer. So the first section that I do for the bay will be about the black eye to the white eye. Is it that's called the black eye? What's that called? You know, the eyeball.
Eyebrow.
I would say
eyebrow.
No, the eyeball, the eyeball. Above the eyeball.
Mm-hmm.
So then we can get, you know, both eyes eyeball in this center. We want to twist it and give some volume. But then both sides, we want to have the bay. So we want to part it above the eyeball, around this section, and then to this like temple area.
And then that's the, you're using that to make a braid that you're gonna wrap to the back.
Yeah, and then on the side, we want to part it above the ear, the top of the ear. It's just like this, like about 1 inch section, and then we bathe from here. Okay, so we're gonna put a couple extensions on her. Mm-hmm. So I kind of create a leaf part of the flower, then we can just hide under the bay.
Yeah, I did the sculpting with the LEDs on because it's possible to over tighten some of the wire connections and it can break the, oh, is that your hair? It can break the wire connections and like on yours, one of the pixels burnt out, for example. So I left it on to make sure that it was working the whole time. So similarly, while you're pinning it, it makes sense for it to be on so that...
You're not damaging it,
right? Or if you're damaging it, you know right away.
Yeah, you don't want to pin this whole thing on.
And then you plug it in and it doesn't light up. Like, that would suck.
That would suck.
Yeah, so it's nice to leave it on just to be sure that you're not damaging any of those tiny little wires.
She used regular bobby pins as well as U-shaped pins to attach the wire structure to the hair. The microcontroller is hidden behind some hair at the base of the skull, and the USB cable can come down over the shoulder or down the back of the shirt. Once Hinano finished my hair, I did hers. Then Hinano showed me an easy and effective technique for making shiny fish scale makeup. And here's the final look. Overall, there's a lot of bang for your buck with this project, and it's sure to impress at your next music festival, mermaid parade, quinceañera, or bat mitzvah. If you do make your own, please share a pic. I love seeing what you make.
Thanks so much for watching. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe with the bell to catch the next one. Check out Hinano's work. I'll put a link to her in the description, and see you next time.
Bye-bye.
This video was made with support from my sponsors and generous donations from viewers like you through Patreon and YouTube memberships.